Good morning, dear students. Welcome back to the class. We are studying our lesson number 1, that is rational numbers. Okay, so what is rational numbers? Let me recall it. It is in the form of p upon q. It is a fraction in which p written in the numerator and q in the denominator, and the condition is that q not equals to 0. Q must not be equals to 0. And in this we completed addition of the rational number, subtraction of the rational numbers and multiplication of the rational numbers, in which we completed some properties of the multiplication of rational numbers. Which properties are there? First property is closure property. Okay, and after that we studied the second property, that is commutative property. But before commutative property, tell me the closure property once again. What is closure property? Closure property is when you multiply two rational numbers, if your answer is again a rational number, then we say that closure property follows. And what about the commutative property? Commutative property is if you change the order of your rational numbers you are multiplying, if your answer remains same, then you say that commutative property follows for the rational numbers. After that, associative property. What is associative property? If you are changing the grouping of rational numbers and still your answer remains same, then you say that associative property follows. Okay? After that, the fourth property is multiplicative identity. What is multiplicative identity? If we are multiplying any rational number with any other rational number and if our answer remains same, or we say that after multiplying a rational number our product is again that rational number, then the number with which we are multiplying that rational number, we say that that is the multiplicative identity, and that number is 1, because if we are multiplying 1 with any rational number our answer is again that rational number. Then after that there is a property, that is multiplication with 0. So, if you are multiplying your rational number with 0, then your answer is always 0. If you are multiplying any rational number with 0, your answer is always 0, because the multiplication of 0 with any number is 0. After that, there is a sixth property, that is multiplicative inverse. Multiplicative inverse is nothing but the reciprocal of rational number and reciprocal of a rational number obtained by interchanging the numerators and denominators. That means you have to write numerator in place of a denominator and denominator in place of a numerator. After that, today we are studying the seventh property, that is distributive property. Which property? Distributive property. What is meant by distribution? Distribution means if we have something in a common, we distribute it to all. अगर हमारे पास कोई चीज है तो हम उसे सब में बांट देते हैं, उसे बोलते हैं distribution. In the same way, distributive property में कोई एक term common होती है तो उसका multiplication bracket के सारी terms में distribute किया जाता है, तो उसी को बोलते हैं distributive property. For example, I am taking that example here. That is 1 by 2 multiplied with 2 by 3 multiplied with 2 by 3 plus 3 by 4 multiplied with 2 by 3 plus 3 by 4. So if you have to multiply distributive property here, how will you apply it? You multiply this common term 1 by 2 with all the 2 terms in the bracket, or all the terms in the bracket. जब इस तरीके से कोई होता है कि आपको एक फ्रैक्शन ब्रैकेट के बाहर दिया होता है, मल्टीप्लिकेशन होता है, तो आपको इस टर्म का मल्टीप्लिकेशन ब्रैकेट के सारी टर्म्स के साथ करना होता है. हाँ, नंबर ऑफ टर्म्स भी रहेगी तो भी आप सभी के साथ मल्टीप्लाई करोगे. हियर ऑनली 2 टर्म्स आर देयर, सो वी आर मल्टीप्लाइंग इट. सो इट बिकम्स 1 by 2 मल्टीप्लाई विथ 2 by 3. 1 by 2 का मल्टीप्लिकेशन हुआ है 2 by 3 के साथ, और उसके बाद होगा 1 by 2 का मल्टीप्लिकेशन 3 by 4 के साथ. ओके, दिस 1 by 2 भी मल्टीप्लाई विद 2 by 3 एज वेल एज दिस 1 by 2 मल्टीप्लाई विद 3 by 4. द मल्टीप्लिकेशन ऑफ 1 by 2 टेकन प्लेस विद 2 by 3 एज वेल एज 3 3 by 4. Now tell me the answer. What will be the answer? 2. Iska kya answer aayega? Bolo. 2 1 2 2 cancel out. 2 1 2 cancel out. Okay, so your answer becomes 1 upon 3. Your answer becomes 1 upon 3. And after that, your plus symbol. And the second term is 1 into 3 is 3. And in the denominator, 2 into 4 is equals to 8. After that, you have to perform the addition of both of them. After that, you have to perform the addition of both of them. So, if you have to add both the 2, since the denominators are different, you are taking the LCM or the cross multiplication method, any you want. I will take the cross multiplication method here because since there are only 2 terms. So, it becomes 1 into 8 plus 3 into 3, and in the denominator it becomes 3 into 8. So, it becomes 8 plus 9, and in the denominator it is 24, so it becomes 17. 20. So the simplification for the question like this is that first you have to multiply this common term with all the terms in the bracket. What will you have to do? You have to multiply the common term with all the terms in the bracket. After that you perform the simplification of them. Okay, so how will you write, taking into the consideration that this symbol is associated with this 1 by 2. 1 by 2 के साथ ये सिंबल है, तो आप पहले लिखोगे 1 by 2 multiplied with 2 by 3 and 1 by 2 multiplied with 3 by 2 and in between the symbol that is in the bracket. Bracket में जो सिंबल है वो आएगा उनके बीच में, ठीक है? फिर आप करोगे इसका सॉल्यूशन, उसे लिखना है, सेकंड टर्म का सॉल्यूशन उसे लिखोगे, दोनों का एडिशन करना है. Okay, this is your distributive property. If there are 3 rational numbers, then how will you multiply it? Okay. So, based on this, there is an exercise. Based on the multiplication, there is an exercise. Which exercise? Exercise 1C. So, now we are taking exercise 1C. Okay. So, exercise 1C. So, exercise 1C, what is your question number 1? Question number 1 is, multiply and write in the simplest form. Multiply and write in the simplest form. So, you have to multiply the given terms and write in the simplest form is, that means you have to write in a shortest form. That means you have to write in a shortest form. So, I will solve one question of each, that is question number 1. 1, 26 upon 9, 26 upon 9, multiply with 27 upon 39, 27 upon 39. So, tell me here, you will multiply your number directly or your cancellation will be easy for you here. So tell me here, आप कौन सा method prefer करोगे, multiplication करने वाला या cancellation करने वाला? So the cancellation method is easy and always preferable. हमें हमेशा अगर cancellation होता है तो उसे करना है. So our solution becomes 26 upon 9 multiplied with 27 upon 39. So, you have to cancel here, that is 13, 2 is 26 and 13, 3 is 39. Remember that, ये जो आप cancellation कर रहे हो, ये work आपको pen से नहीं करना है. ये जो आप cancel करोगे numbers को, ये आपको pencil से करना है, so that it must be clearly understandable. Okay, otherwise जब हम cancel करते हैं, numbers लिखते हैं, तो वो समझ में नहीं आता. तो आप जो cancellation करोगे वो आपको pencil से करना है, ठीक है? So 13 2s are 26 and 13 3s are 39 and 9 1s are 9 and 9 3s are 27. 9 3s are 27. So your numerator becomes 2 multiplied by 3 and your denominator becomes 1 into 3. Your numerator becomes 2 into 3 and your denominator becomes 2 into 3 and your denominator denominator become 1 into 3. Again, 3 ones are 3 and 3 ones are 3. Remember that you can't cut numerator with a numerator, but you can cut your numerator with denominator. आप numerator और denominator की एक-एक term को cancel कर सकते हो, but numerator से numerator या denominator से denominator को cancel नहीं करना. ठीक है? So now your numerator becomes 2 into 1 and in the denominator it becomes 1 into 1. So your final answer is 2 because in the denominator there is a 1 into 1, that is 1 itself, and if there is a 1 in the denominator, we can skip it. Okay? So this is your question number 1. After that, there is a question number 2, that identify the property of multiplication associated with each of the following. That means in all the 4 questions given in that, you have to write the name of the property. So the first question is 3/7 multiply with -4/9, and it is equals to -4/9 multiply with 3/7. You can see that there is a interchanging of your rational numbers, or there is a change in the order of the rational number. So you can say that this is a commutative property. Which property is this? It is a commutative property. Okay. So in this way, you have to write the remaining property as well. Now I am solving question number 3 here. Okay. So what is question number 3? Question number 3 is simplify. Question number 3 is simplify. That means in the given question, you have to simplify your question. Okay. So how will you simplify it? Your first question is -3/5. Solution here. -3/5. Multiply with 13/3 plus 2/9 multiply with 13/4. This is your question. Now, first check whether there is any terms which will get cancelled in the question itself. आपको चेक करना है, सबसे पहले सॉल्यूशन में आप जब क्वेश्चन लिख लोगे, उसके बाद सबसे पहले आपको ये चेक करना है कि ऐसी कोई भी टर्म्स अगर आपको वहां दिख रही है जो कैंसिल हो सकती है, तो यू हैव टू कैंसिल इट. सो दिस 2, 3 इज गेट कैंसिल. सो वी राइट इट एज -1/5 मल्टीप्लाई विद 13/1. ओके, सो इट इज कैंसिल. एंड इन द सेकंड टर्म 2 ones are 2 and 2 twos are 4. So you can write 2 ones are 2 and in this you can write 2 twos are 4. Okay, so this is it. Now solve this. You can write -1 into 13, that is -13, and in the denominator 5 into 1, it is equals to 5. After that there is a plus symbol. 1 into 13 is equals to 13, and in the denominator 9 into 2, it is equals to 18. Now you can perform your addition by cross multiplication or the LCM method, whatever you are preferable for you. But here, if you are multiplying -13 with 18, your calculations must be fast. Okay, 5 into 13, -13 into 18 plus 13 into 5, and in the denominator you have to write 5 into 18. You will write 5 into 18. मैंने cross multiplication apply किया, ठीक है? -13 multiply with 18 plus 13 multiply with 5. 13 multiply with 5. Now tell me, what is the multiplication of 13 and 18? What is the multiplication of 13 and 18? Okay, so tell me, what is the multiplication of that? 13 into 18 is equals to how much? 13 into 18 is equals to how much? So 13 8s are 104. So you write 4 here and 10 is 10. So 13 ones are 13 and 10, it is equals to 234. That means -234 plus 13 5s are 65, and in the denominator 5 into 18 is equals to 19. Now you have to cancel, you have to cancel it, otherwise you can write it as your answer. But it is in an improper fashion, so you can write it in a mixed form as well. Okay, so this will be your final answer for the simplification, and you have to solve it in this method. First, you have to cancel the terms in your question if it is, then multiply or addition, whatever question given in your question helps solve. Then the question changes to the addition, subtraction or the multiplication. So if in addition or subtraction denominators are different, make them same and then perform your addition and subtraction. So you have to solve question number 1, 2, 3 of exercise 1C in your notebook. Okay, so till then, bye, take care.